Romans from verse 11 to verse 17. In the month of Lent, we'll be doing the book of Romans that is trying to make a good relationship with these people even before he gets there. That is trying to assure them that he has been thinking about them, that even though he has not visited them yet. Now, there's a saying that says that provision does not precede a vision. So what this apostle is trying to do, he's trying to put in the minds of these people how much he has been thinking about them, that when the time comes for him to actually be in Rome, he will be well received, that he will not need a lot of introduction because he has already introduced himself to them. He has not met these people. He actually says that he has longed to go and visit them. And that is why he is assuring them that he longs to go and see him. And during this time of Lent, we are counting the days, or the 40 days, when we are commemorating the time that Jesus Christ was in the wilderness and he was fasting for 40 days. If there is something Jesus Christ did at this particular moment in time, is that he was fasting because of the ministry that was ahead of him. That he'd actually prepared himself. He took the time to prepare fast before he started his ministry. Earlier in the day today, we were in a fellowship and we were being asked, why do people go through tests? And why do people go through temptations? Because one thing that Jesus Christ went through was when he was preparing for his ministry is the temptations that he went through. And one thing that we can record from that is that before we can go to any level, before we can be promoted to the next class, there is a test that we must go through. That is very common. That anybody here who went to high school, before they went to high school, they had to sit for their KCPE examination. And now Jesus Christ was preparing for their ministry, and you find himself here being tempted by the devil. And now you find Paul here, he is preparing himself. He is preparing himself for the mission and for the time he shall go to see the people of Rome. And there is something that he is highlighting about living by faith and being justified by faith. Because these people were not so familiar with the word that he was preaching, like Reverend Ann highlighted in the last time, that he had to prepare these people mentally for the time that he comes there, he shall be well received. So even us during this time of Lent season, it is a high time for us to prepare ourselves, even for the times that are coming in our lives. We will go through tests, we will go through trials, and these things that happen to us and come into our lives, they are not to defeat us, they are not to wipe us out, but they are there to elevate us and promote us to the next level. If you look at the life of Paul, it wasn't the sweetest life that any one of us could want to live. He was in chains so many times. He was beaten so many times. But yet, today we read a lot and so many books and letters that were written by this man. Actually, the New Testament is largely contributed by this apostle. So during this Lent season, it is also good to prepare ourselves these 40 days, that as we leave the Lent season, it may make us to be better people. It may draw us even closer in the presence of God. We are talking about fasting and denying ourselves the things that we love. When we do that, it should draw us in the presence of God. That when we fast, we seek the presence of God. That when we deny ourselves the things that we love, we should substitute them with the things that are positive. And if there is anything that we can actually prepare ourselves, it is meeting our God, our Lord, and our Savior, Jesus Christ. In this month, we are having the theme in the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 28, where the theme is coming from, that we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken. And I believe that nothing happened in this world without a reason. That Paul prepared himself for this, And even us, we are also preparing ourselves for a kingdom that is coming. Like I highlighted the other day when I was preaching in the English service and the Kikuyu service, that the kingdom that we are receiving is a kingdom that cannot be shaken and a kingdom that cannot be brought down. And there's a verse that says, until the good news of the kingdom is preached, the end cannot come. So even as we are in the Lent season, let us prepare ourselves. Let us prepare ourselves mentally for the coming of the kingdom of God. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.